My name's Darren McDermott. I run Brooklyn's Amateur Boxing Club, which I've been doing since 2011. We started off in our back garden in a shed built by my father-in-law. 2011, I think we started with around four local kids. Since then, we've actually grown, and I'd say we've probably got 90 members in the gym working on a six-day week.
My name is Peter Loipman. I'm a photographer. I'm a retired teacher, as it happens, but I'm fine now, thank you. I now do photography more or less full-time as freelance, doing news, stock, features and so on. Work published in Times, Telegraph, Sun, Daily Mail and so on, and also for magazines and so on, and websites. So I do weddings as well and social media stuff and that kind of thing.
I started boxing when I was 8 years of age for Dudley Amateur Boxing Club. Won a schoolboy title at the age of 14. Went on Midland Honours as a senior. I turned pro at 25. Won a British Masters, Midland Middleweight Championship, English Middleweight Championship. Boxed for the British and the Commonwealth. Ranked number three in Great Britain before having a subdural hematoma, which finished my career.
This portrait project is absolutely fantastic. It's a great opportunity to do a lot of work where I live, not just for those in London and Manchester, but where I live.
Yeah. Subdural hematoma is like a blister on the brain. I actually had a subdural hemorrhage, which was a bleed on the brain, but while trying to repair the bleed, they found an aneurysm on the other side, which is the hematoma.
In portraits, I prefer to take pictures of the people where they're happiest, where they're most comfortable, where they work, where they live, not where I live, but where they live.
I started when I was 8 years of age, basically, not a little terror, but obviously a little bit full on. Dad decided needed a little bit of discipline, a little bit of respect, so took me to the local boxing club. To me, he put me on the right track.
I prefer to take pictures of Darren in his club with his people, his volunteers, his boxers, his the lads and lasses who all come here every day, and get a picture that shows all those things coming together.
Boxing to me, I just feel that the stuff that it gives you back, the rewards it gives you back, as in like the dedication, the fitness, the well-being, the healthiness, everything I get from boxing is what I love about boxing.
I want to try and show visually, primarily leadership, which is what Darren gives his kids every day, is leadership. They go to school, yeah, they're led at school. At home, I presume they're led at home by parents, of course they are, but here it's different leadership. It's a different voice from teacher or sir or miss, different voice from mum and dad or uncle. It's Darren's voice telling them straight what to do, what not to do. And you can see it in these kids' faces. And I want to show that, but that's what Darren does for these kids and his families.
Obviously, after having a subdural hematoma and the bleed on the brain, I could have gone off the track a little bit, but my wife says to me, why don't you turn that gym that you've got, what you train yourself in, into a club for the kids, and put a little bit back into it, which I did.
Volunteering is very important to the community, wherever you live, wherever you are, however old you are, or if you're working or not, because volunteering is a chance to give things back that you've taken before. I spent 33 years teaching. Now it's time for me to give things back and not expect payment.
I get more out of kids than I do training adults. I think the kids will give you 120% more than an adult would. An adult will give you 98%, unless he's feeling a bad day, and then he'll give you 95%. A kid, doesn't matter if he's had an hard day at school, he'll come down the gym and he will give you 100% every time he comes in the gym.
The reward is being out there and getting my work being shown, to people who wouldn't normally see it, and also meeting people like Darren and the kids here. That's what you get. That's the reward.
People ask me about boys and girls boxing. What do I think of it? From the Olympics, the girls that have come into the boxing is unbelievable. I'd say trebled, if not quadrupled. The girls are found. Give you twice as much as the boys do. I think probably trying to prove a point that they're as good as the boys, but equally as good as each other. I won't be able to pick one from another to say who would rather train.
When you're doing photography, your life experiences are so important, because you can't walk in with a camera. It's not going to work. You have to bring in all your experiences, your knowledge of people, how they talk, how they act, who they are. I don't know who they are, but they know who they are. And so you walk in there, and you can't suss out someone straight away, but you know who's in charge. And so you can walk into a club like this and see who's in charge, who's being led, and where they're going. And that's what I've got to try and show that.
Seeing as boxing is a discipline of weight and whatever else, it's a bit hard with girls, obviously, depending on what girls you are now, how developed they are, the weight's a bit of an issue. But to me, having girls, I'll have to find out the hard way with the weight and whatever else, but we can get in there. The girls listen to me, they try their hardest, and all I can ask for is if they give me 100%, then I'll stick with it and we'll go from there.
I want to show the whole picture, literally the whole picture of the club, but somewhere central in there is Darren and what he's doing. I've got to show that absolutely. It could be Darren with all the boxers around him and all the volunteers around him, or it could be Darren into the foreground and a box at the background. I've got so many ideas what we can do here. But central in there and absolutely in pin sharp focus is Darren.
I probably wouldn't be here if it hadn't been for Claire anyway. She saved my life by ringing her uncle in France, who was a retired ear, nose and throat surgeon. He demanded that Claire took me back to the hospital, demanded that I got a scan, which I did, which they found the hematoma and the bleed. So obviously Claire's more backbone, to be fair, so yeah, brilliant. She does everything for the club, everything that you don't see from behind the scenes, paperwork, cards, medicals, first aid courses, everything's run through by Claire, so she's probably the backbone of the Brooklands Amateur Boxing Club.
The pre-knowledge of meeting someone like this is absolutely essential. You can't walk in, get a picture and walk out. We all know that. I hope we all know that. I think meeting someone like Darren first gets my respect straight away. What I've seen, the respect is straight there. I could never do what Darren's doing now or in the past, obviously. I'm not a boxer. But to meet him now, I can now look at things that the qualities of what he does, the outcomes of what he does, the leadership that he shows, and these kids responding. It's evidential just by seeing the kids, what they're doing, what they're not saying. It's absolutely crucial.
I'd highly recommend boxing, yeah. I know people say to me, why do you do it? You don't get nothing from it. No, it's voluntary, that's what it is. The rewards we get is when you see the likes of Paige Goodyear, Mitchell Stevens come through winning belts, winning titles, being picked for GB squads and world championships. That is enough reward and payment for me anyway.
You're welcome straight away. By respect, it's eye contact, they're boxing, they get on with it. They don't look at you twice, because you're a visitor, you're a guest, but they carry on boxing. That's why they're here, not here for me. They're boxing for Darren, boxing themselves, boxing for the families. And there's one lad who packed up, he warmed down, he packed up, got dressed, shook my hand before he left. No words, just shook my hand. Where would you see that? And see it in schools.
Someone once told me, any publicity is good publicity. So if it puts the gym on the map somewhere to show what we do in wood setting, obviously voluntary, and get people to help us. Obviously we're more self-funded, everything we do, backpacks and whatever else, trying to raise a little bit of cash for the gym. But if we can get noticed by just letting people out there know what we do for the community, then yeah, definitely everybody should try and get into these projects.